After finishing adjusting the weight, vertex painting, and adding thickness to your item, we can now export it to Unity. But first, ensure that all parts of your item are joined together. So let me just hide the mask and the armature first. Then, here in the outliner, I will select the name of the mesh that doesn't have any extra number attached in it and bring my cursor back in the 3D viewport and press Ctrl-J. Unhide the mask and the armature. For the mask, it is important to remove the armature modifier first. So if you did not remove this, the mask will create a clone in Unity and you won't be able to make a prefab out of it and export it as a ZEPETO file. There are three objects that you need to include in exporting: the mask, the armature, and your item. If you have any other objects in your workflow, such as the high poly version of your item and picture references, please do not include them in your selection. After that, go to File, Export, FBX. Then we need to tweak a couple of options here. First, make sure to tick the box here in Selected Objects so that, from the term itself, the objects that you selected, which are the mask, armature, and your item, will be the only ones to be included in the export. In the armature category, please uncheck Add Leaf Bones so that there won't be any extra bones attached to your model. An example of an FBX with leaf bones attached to it is this. And if you import to work with it once again, it sometimes messes up the rigging process if you want to fix the rigging because of the double bones. After that, you can now export it as an FBX and save it somewhere you will remember. After you open your Unity editor, go here in the Asset folder, then Contents. You have the choice to create a new folder so that all of your creations will be together in one place. Or, you could just simply drag the FBX in the Contents folder. If you created a new folder, open it and drag the FBX there. Personally, I created a bookmark of the folder here in Unity in Blender so that I can export it directly to Unity. So if you want to do that, you are free to do so. Now that the FBX is here, we can convert it into a prefab file. To do that, right-click the FBX, ZEPETO Studio, Convert to ZEPETO Style. Now a new file will pop up, which we call the prefab as indicated below. Now, let's make our model where our item. Click Loader and choose here on the right side of the screen the category of the item that you just made. For this example, I made the dress, so I will tick the Clothes Dress box. Then, I will drag the prefab file here in the non-object. If you want your own avatar to model your item here in Unity, just simply enter your ZEPETO code, not the username or ID, here in the hash code text box. You can find your ZEPETO code if you try to copy the link of one of your ZEPETO posts and retrieve the last 6 characters in the link. So my ZEPETO code is RTK518. Then after that, click the play button here in the middle top part and wait for your avatar to appear. I prefer switching here in the scene tab so that we can zoom in a little bit closer to our avatar and item as well. For the controls, to zoom in or out, you can simply scroll the scroll wheel of your mouse. To move the view, just press and hold your mouse scroll wheel and pan the screen. To rotate the view, press and hold Alt in your keyboard while pressing the left click in your mouse. Now, if you click the play like button in the prefab, the materials that you made way back in Blender can be found here. This is where you will put your designs. To put a simple pattern, I have one prepared here in my Unity. So click the material first, then change the shader from standard to width standard. Then drag the pattern to the first box you can find here. Make sure that the image size is set to 512 by 512 and that the format is in PNG. You can use the most basic photo editor to do this if you are lazy to find other photo editing apps such as Paint, which is a default photo editor on your computer. If you also have your own design which you made for in your UV map, this is where you will place it too. For the normal map that we baked, we will put it here in the second box. If you're done designing your item, just convert the prefab into ZEPETO style once again to lock in your design. Then, to have our ZEPETO file, we need to go out of play mode. So let's select the play button once again. Then right-click the prefab, ZEPETO Studio, export as .zepeto. A blank file will appear here, which is what we call the ZEPETO file as indicated again below. This ZEPETO file is what we will upload in ZEPETO Studio. As usual, log in to your account, select the Create button, and choose Item. Just close whatever pops up on your screen, if any, then choose Create item with 3D file. Close the pop-up again and then choose among the categories here depending on the type of item that you did. So for me, I'll go with dress. And now we can just simply drag the ZEPETO file from Unity here in ZEPETO Studio. After loading, you can now fill up the necessary information. So let me just add a name. Then, the category of my item is casual because it has two parts, the top and skirt. If you're not sure about the category of your dress, you can check the ZEPETO shop and find similar items to see which category your item falls in. For the tags, these are just the hashtags that you want to include in your item, so when the other users search for a specific tag, your item will appear under it. Then, the price. It's up to you by how much you will price it. The minimum is 1 gem and the maximum is 50 gems. Here in the advanced settings, you have the choice to release your item once ZEPETO Studio has reviewed your item and approved it. Or you can set a specific date when your item will be released. Just select the set a start/end date. You will just fill up the start date, because if you added a date for the end, your item will disappear from your shop from the date that you indicated and it will stop generating sales. In setting up a schedule, you have to consider the review time of ZEPETO Studio in your item. So it doesn't mean that when you schedule a date, it will automatically be released that day. For example, you submitted the dress today and you scheduled it tomorrow, it will not be released from your shop because the usual review time of ZEPETO Studio for premium users is usually 2 to 3 days, and for non-premium users, it can go up to 7 days. So, if you have scheduled your item and ZEPETO Studio is not yet done reviewing it on the day that you set, your item, unfortunately, will not appear in the new list in the creator shop. And I think that's a bad thing because your item's exposure to the public will be less. So, you really have to give a generous gap in scheduling your item. I am a premium user, so from today, I will count 5 days after to set the schedule. This is just my preferred gap. You can go lower or higher as long as you consider the review time. Then also, set the time that I want. In this example, let's schedule 9 a.m. After filling up everything, you can try to view your item on your phone by clicking this preview on your phone, and you will receive a notification about your item. Usually, after filling up everything on this page, we will submit our item already. But just like I said in our previous lessons, what you see in Blender is different from what you see in ZEPETO. So to be sure that your item has no errors in it, we will check it thoroughly in ZEPETO. And that will be in our next video, which will also include the fixing process if ever that our item has errors in it. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something new for today. See you in the next one. Bye!